Hey guys, Andy here, and today on Andy Talks Navy, I'm going to be sharing with you five things you need to know about the post 9/11 GI Bill. So, let's get started. The full 36 months of benefits only applies to months that you're in school. So, a common misconception among recently transitioning veterans is that you only get paid 36 months to go to school, and then you got to figure out what to do for that last year of school. But those 36 months are only applicable to months that you are in school. So if you take summers off, those months aren't being run because you're not in school. But conversely, if you do decide to take summer classes, like myself, then they will start running. But the advantage of that is that you're gonna graduate faster. So make it that as you will. You only get paid the E5 with kids BA age during the months that you're in school. When I first started college, I started in the spring semester, the very beginning of 2016. I was expecting to get my first BAH payment that January when I started, but I didn't get my first BAH payment until the following month, near the end of January, beginning of February. And the reason being is that the months are paid for the days that you're actually in class, and is paid for the month previous. So because I didn't have classes in December, I didn't get any payment in January. But because I had classes in January, I got paid in February. Your BAH is prorated during months where you have a break, such as during Christmas or New Year's. So you will not be paid for days that school is not in session. So again, this was something that I had to learn the hard way, especially when I was first starting off in college. And because I start off in the spring semester just getting off of Christmas break, I only got basically half month's worth of BAH because of how winter break was divvied up in my college. So when I finally got that sweet BAH payment in February, I only got like half the check, and I was wondering like, what's going on? And then I found out that it's prorated for days that class is in session. So keep that in mind when budgeting. You won't receive your first BAH payment until after the end of the first month of school. But there's something else I didn't cover. You will, however, receive your book stipend check at the beginning of the month, usually within the first week or two. But if you need your books right away for classes, some colleges, like mine, have a book loan program that you can repay once you get your stipend. So basically, you go in, you figure out exactly how much money all of your books costs, then you have them ring it up, figure out the exact price, then you go over to your student loan office, financial aid, whatever you want to call it, have them ring up a book loan for you, and they basically, it's like a little ticket, and says you have to repay the loan in within 30 days, which that's usually more than enough time to get the book loan, or the book stipend rather. And so you take that down to the bookstore, they ring you up, and you get all your books free of charge at the time. So, but once your book stipend comes in, then you have to go in and repay the loan and you're good to go. If you fail a class, you can retake it. And a lot of colleges will erase your failing grade and replace it with your passing grade if you retake the class and pass. When I first started college, I had been removed from the education environment for almost a decade at that point. So even though I'm a fairly intelligent person, hashtag humble brag, I was not used to the student mindset and the student way of doing things. So it took me a long time, actually, about a year, to kind of get back into that groove of studying for tests, setting aside time to do assignments. When grade time comes, sometimes you fail a class, and it can be very discouraging, especially for veterans who are used to excelling in their field, and then finding out that they have shortcomings for whatever reason can be very discouraging. But just know that if you fail a class, it's not the end of the world, and you can retake it. And a lot of colleges have the policy that if you retake a class and pass, they'll replace your failing grade with the passing grade, which will dramatically improve your GPA. So if you're worried about that, then that's the best way to improve your GPA. So with that said, guys, those are the five things you need to know about the post 9/11 GI Bill. And with that said, this is the Andy San, signing off for now. And as always, we'll see you next time. Catch you later, guys. Bye.